Hello. Okay, there we go. Back in Barovia. So, good evening, everybody. Nice to see you. And Zenicus, my Aladrin friend.
Yeah.
Would you care to recap for us the frolics and frivolities and festive fun times of last time?
You can call it that. Yeah, so after, the most important story of last week was that Zenicus did not find any pies. After searching under floorboards.
Hashtag pray for Zenicus.
He's incredibly upset. But while he was searching, everyone else had coming back from their lovely hat shopping and came past the stocks.
Sticky. Where they...
Yeah, where they saw lots of people being kind of stuck in there for what was it? What was the exact phrase?
Blitzing the Burger Master, essentially.
Yes, malicious unhappiness. To which everyone else was, felt that this was a bit of injustice going on here, rightfully so. Vanta trying to get information from people. Like that, was trying to wonder if maybe she could get captured, and they asked the rest of the group if they thought this was a good idea. Asara wisely suggested turning things up to 11. To which Vanta, I think, skipped 11 and went up to like 14.
Yes.
And went for complete an utter malicious unhappiness and mockery of the Burgomaster, which is completely frowned upon after all the great and beautiful work he's done to protect this town, and was quickly thrown in the stocks, where she met the most hideous of all criminals. Who had been stealing office supplies.
Oh my god. Can you believe it?
Izek, the big, crazy, monster-armed captain of the guard, I guess, told the rest of the party to just get lost before they caused any more trouble. To which they came back to Zenicus and Arena, kind of sitting down having lunch as he was upset about the lack of pies. We found out from the barkeep Markinoff that Rictavio buys a lot of raw meat for some reason, for some sort of creature that he keeps held. Also found out about the true nature of the pies. The meat's fine. Everything's fine. There's no problems with the meat. But there is bones grinded into the pastry.
Okay.
Just a little side note there.
Yeah.
And that they want rid of the hags, the Markinoffs. They've quite a big family that seem to be involved in a lot of things, including the wine trade.
Sorry, let me correct just one thing there. Martikoffs.
Martikoffs. Yes. Sorry. Yes, so their big family seem involved in a lot more than they'd originally let on. They're trying to get us involved in that too. Hopefully for the better. We'll find out soon enough. And we talked to Arena and try to get the meeting that we had cancelled with Izek uncancelled so that we could get Vanta out of trouble. And we head out with a letter from Arena, who also sent one back to her brother to try and get rid of the hag who'd been visiting Barovia.
Indeed.
And we met Izek along the road, who was dragging Vanta quite roughly through the town, and we didn't even get a chance to speak. We just got thrown against the closest wall and dragged through the streets because I think, what was it Vanta said, that we were all complicit in multiple crimes?
Yeah.
Happened to just subtly drop that down.
She has no charisma. Why do you keep letting her do things? I don't understand.
I didn't.
I don't know why I do anything, to be honest, though. It's
just thought, like, oh, I'm in trouble. What else should I do? Well, what happens if everyone else is in trouble, too? That'll work out for the best.
Zero charisma!
So, yeah. So he came to arrest all of us and get rid of all this farce. We convinced him to at least speak to Arena before any of that happened. And as he barged open the door to the inn, he saw Arena and started creepily going, ha ha ha!
Oh, it freaked me out.
That was so terrifying.
Terrifying.
And screamed, my dear sister. And that is where we ended.
Okay. Thank you very much.
And that was the most terrifying part, though. The jumping out, like, everything else was horror, was fine. His reaction was horrifying.
Yes. So, yeah, we find ourselves back all looking on wide-eyed and open-mouthed, the town guards around the walls included, as there is a loud clatter and clang as Izek's large battle axe falls noisily to the floor. And he goes to his knees in front of Irina Kolyana. My dear sister, he repeats again as he takes her hands in his. She winces slightly as his claw grabs hold of one of her hands, and he's like, I'm so sorry.
We're still being, like, held quite roughly, aren't we?
Nobody is holding on to anything at the moment, I don't think.
Okay, everyone.
No, you were kind of pushed into the bar room, okay. Ahead, you know, into the inn's main room.
I want to start slinking into the shadows where I belong.
Probably for the best.
I kind of just do my eldritch kind of hover there.
Pull it back down to, like, a 2.
I'm sleep over this future figure. Go ahead, I'm on fire.
And I think if nobody says anything, Arena's just like, and she kind of politely, yeah, like, withdraws her hands from his, and she's like, I'm sorry, I don't know you. What are you talking about? And he's like, and he looks very, you know, embarrassed and the loss of his normal composure, and he snaps back to his original self very quickly, and he stands up. And his monstrous hand snatches up the battle axe from the floor, and he turns to the guards. He's like, "You lot, secure the entrances. I must determine the innocence or guilt of these suspects." And
can I roll a stealth check?
They're all like a little slow to move, because they're still just like completely freaked out by how he reacted. And he's like, "No!" And you see his hand like flares with flame around the claw. And across the scales of his arm there, and they all just like, yes sir, and they go running out, and you hear them spreading out, and you get moving around the building on the outside, and the door is closed, and Izek turns his face softer again.
Don't worry, it's just a little thing I was saying to get them out. I wouldn't charge you with anything. You're the ones who brought my sister to Valaki, back. We are together again.
Safely.
So who's adopted?
And Irina's like, what are you talking about? My brother is in Barovia. I have a brother, yes, but it's not you. And he's like, oh, my dear, I'm sorry. I didn't even know your name. Was it, Irina? And she's like, yes, Irina Kolyana. The burgomaster's daughter from the village of Barovia, visiting here to see your baron. And he's like, yes, this must be, and he turns on Danica, who's like stood there with like a, oh, I'm going to get so much mileage out of this tonight. like on her face. And he's like,
this is a soap opera for her.
He's like, you, a stiff drink for my sister and her, escort. And she immediately looks worried again. She, you know, she's terrified of Vizek. And she's like, yes, of course. She brings out cups and a clear liquid. A shot of a clear liquid is poured into each small cup, placed on a table, kind of in the center there. And Izek is like, he just slams his back. He's like, ah, please, have a seat. Allow me to explain what I know. But then you must tell me on everything I've missed. Oh, I can't believe it. I just can't believe it.
Oh, it's wild.
No.
I don't think any of us can believe it either.
I said...
We've all committed terrible crimes.
I said... Sit down.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Sit.
And he pulls, and like Irina sits like at the table with the table between them, and has her hands like joined on the table in front of her, and he sits down like facing all of you, you kind of like in a semicircle, kind of facing him almost, and he's like, oh, where to begin? From the beginning, I guess. It's a very good place to start.
I knew you were going to say that.
Yeah.
Hey, you were doing it last week. Come on.
Counting down the seconds.
Nobody needs to know.
Irina. He can't like control himself. He's just grinning from ear to ear. It's like this, not a face you've seen on him since, you know, the few times you've met. The short, enjoyable time you spent together.
Oh yeah, real fun. Remember those days?
Mm-hmm. Vanta just has a quick flashback of like skipping through the town square and then like slow motion thrown into the stocks, a big grin on her face. You know, slow motion spear butt to the face. Happy times. My sister, we hail from Kresk. Originally, we were traveling. I know not where. I was quite small, and you were just a teeny baby. We were traveling on our way, I assume, here. But before we reached this safety, the Baron's safety, we were attacked. Vicious wolves. Barreling out of the trees. Our parents tried to protect us. They were good people, I think. They tried to protect us, and unfortunately, I'm sorry to tell you, they were killed. It was the trauma of seeing that before my very eyes, the danger I was in, and my desire to protect you, that first ignited my gift. And he pulls out, you know, he pulls his cloak off, the scaly, clawed, spiny hand, and he lets fire play over the hand again. It had never happened before. We thought it was just a hideous malformity. But the stress of the situation, my fear for your life, it ignited with a mighty burst of flame and destroyed three of the wolves. The others fled for their lives, but not before they snatched up you in your swaddling clothes and bore you away. I chased after them, but I was only small. I couldn't keep up. I searched
I searched the woods for so long. I killed a great many more creatures in the forest. But I couldn't find you. I'm so sorry. I couldn't find you. And I wandered, distraught, weak, useless, until I came across the palisade here of Valaki. I was allowed in, hiding my arm as I had, and the guards let me in, fearing for a young child out in the woods, curious that I was alone. And the Baron, bless his soul, the Baron took me in, raised me, gave me employ with his guard, and I have been making sure that everything here is to his liking, as it should be, within the walls of Valaki. It was later that the dreams started. Once a year, on what I feel must be some special day for you, maybe your name day. Once a year, in my dreams, I saw you. But not the same. I saw you growing. So I knew in my heart that you were safe, somewhere in Barovia. But every time, as I awoke and darkness faded from the sky, so too did my memory of the dream, my memory of you, my sister. So, that's when I decided the next year I wasn't going to let that happen. I woke in the morning, and I rushed up the street from the Baron's manor to Blinsky's, and I made him a description of what I'd seen before the vision faded, and he, bless his soul, his weird, creepy soul, he created a near likeness, not perfect, but fair enough to remember you and to immortalize each year the growth, the maturing of my sister. And it was enough. It kept the memory, it kept the dreams alive. And now, but I don't need to ask that creepy little man to do that anymore. The dreams are alive. You are alive. And you are here with me once more. And he just slips out of his chair onto his knees once more. My sister, I'm so sorry I couldn't find you. I couldn't keep you from those beasts. I don't know why they didn't kill you, eat you up, but I'm glad that they didn't. I'm so glad that you're here. I'm so glad.
And you can see, actually, that Irina is actually crying, too.
I mean, you don't look like Ismark.
And she looks to you, actually, Asara.
Do you have it?
I'm trying to remember if I have it on my person or my pack. I'm gonna say it's in my pocket. I would have gotten it after the whole thing.
Okay.
I'm gonna be like, and give her the paper.
Thank you. Isaac.
He's just like, his like shoulders are like shaking silently on the floor. Isaac. And she walks around the table and puts a gloved hand on his shoulder. I didn't see you. I didn't know about you as you did, but somehow, some part of me, there was a connection. And she unfolds the paper and proffers it to him. And he reaches up curiously and he's like, You drew this? She's like, yes, when I was 3, 4? I'm sorry, it's a silly thing. And he's like, no. It shows, and it proves this is all true. She's like, to think, the weird monster man. It was my brother. I have a brother. A real brother. What are we going to tell Ismark?
He has more family.
Yeah, he's not your brother now. Sorry,
we better both
of course. I know. Everything we have from growing up together. I know. And Isaac is like, yes. He is to be thanked for being there for you when I could not. I'm so glad that you came here. That you decided to reach out to Valaki. And forge this connection between the towns. And Irina looks to him and says, it's not the only reason I came. Is Mark and Isaac is too close. It's not the only reason. The devil was pestering me. Trying to. I don't know what. And she lowers her ruffed collar. Look. And Isaac shoots to his feet. Oh! Irina! What did the devil do? She's like, I don't know. He bewitched me. He bit me. But he didn't turn me. I have some of your fire in my blood, too. But I came here to get away from the shadow of that cursed castle. And Isaac's like, yes, the Baron here, he has forged a safe place. The devil does not dare show his face around here. I was right in hoping that here, or maybe Kresk, would be a safe place. And Isaac's like, yes, there will be guards. City guards will be watching you, with you, wherever you go. Maybe the church. Have you been to the church? Maybe they can. That is hallowed ground. The devil, even if he came, he could not enter that, surely. And Irina nods. Yes, I was meaning to go and pay my respects. This is a lot. And he's like, yes. Look, I'm happy you're here and I know you're safe. I will be close by. I'm sorry, my duties. I have to go. I have to be about town. I have to be looking out for ne'er-do-wells like her. Points at Vanta. But he has a smile playing about the corners of his mouth. And he actually stomps over to you where you're kind of in, under, maybe under the stairs, where the stairs come down.
Yeah.
He's like, do you hiss from the shadows?
That's no.
He's like,
I'm confused.
You.
Yes.
I don't know why you would say such things about the Baron. He's a good man.
He's practicing.
Don't. Do it again.
I can't.
And he leans his battle axe against the stair banister, and he clamps both hands, including the giant clawed one on your shoulders, and draws you out from under the stairs. And he gives you a big hug. He's like, thank you. And he goes to all of you, and thank you.
Whoa.
And you. And you.
What is that? What is You've that?
Brought my dreams to reality.
No. And now you will help me bring mine to fruition as well.
I will do what when... I can. But be warned. If you speak out against our ways too much, if you cause too much trouble, even I will not be able to protect you. And I will have to do the Baron's bidding. No matter who you are or what you have done for my sister.
I want everyone to know that, like, Krig would be the last person that he hugged. Mm-hmm. And Krig definitely would have, like, fully leaned into it and been like, oh yeah, like, and like held him, and that entire last part of Izzik's speech was like over Krig's shoulder because he's just like
don't let go
in,
bird
like,
hug enjoy in.
Koala.
Yeah
I enjoy, we can enjoy.
He's like, no, I really must
plying you off,
get back to my duties.
Duties.
And he holds out his normal hand to Irina and clasps hers, and she offers it back and takes his. And
her.
I'll see you later, sister.
And she's like, aye, brother. That you will. And he's like, and goes to the door and stoops down against the light daylight outside.
You nuts! Come on, with me!
Barks, and you hear guards falling behind him, march off through the town. And you are left alone?
So this is wonderful.
Yeah!
That was a lot. As Krig is like kind of picking himself up off the floor and like straightening his feathers.
Yes, was.
Yeah, are you affection starved or what was that?
Oh no, it's just a thing that we do. It's like a warmth thing. Yeah, yes.
Zenica just goes in.
Enjoy being hugged forever now.
Zenica is loving this right now. He's like so happy.
Krig is surprisingly light. So
he gives him that little bit of a lift up.
Yeah, those hollow bird bones.
I'm gonna like go up to Irina and be like, so how's your day?
To who, sorry?
Irina.
Irina.
She's like collapsed down. She's like, Danica, could I have another? And Danica pours all of the glasses again.
Danica just put his like feet up on a table, like leaning back, like listening to all this with the biggest smile on his face.
All right, Blondie.
You got a brother and a boyfriend, apparently.
Boyfriend?
Your dinner. Your book, all that.
Vasily? No, he's just a friend. He's just
very interesting fellow.
You start? And then I'm gonna finish my drink.
I'll have to be careful if my brother doesn't approve. Yikes.
If he brings you a rock, be careful.
A rock?
You know, like stone, like a gem, like in the ring.
That's a bird.
With a K or without, because without is very terrifying.
with a K. Like a good round rock, maybe about yay big.
I think this guy is. Like, that's massive.
I am realizing now this is an Arakokra thing.
Oh yes, Arakokra.
Please, I'm learning a lot about them.
Yes, I hope we have the chance to talk more.
I'm going to tell him to bring you a rock.
Don't tell him that.
And Danica says, I'll leave the bottle. I'm going to start getting ready. The evening rush will begin before too long.
I wasn't lying earlier. I did learn something.
Wait, when you said that we were all criminals, or?
No, when I said, well, yes, I suppose I have to be a bit more specific, don't I? When I was saying to Izuk that, well, the Baron is practicing dark magic.
Ooh, nice. What kind?
Not the kind that produces an amber light. So not worth my time.
What do you mean?
I'm gonna look at Xenicus and be like, see, sometimes you need an 11.
What did you hear?
Ooh. I heard from the gatekeeper who was stealing the quill.
The poor man.
He was what?
He was stealing quill.
Wow. What kind of people in this town?
Crick turns around, he's got a big bear patch.
Truly abhorrent.
A bald patch.
I heard that they seen Greenlit go to his... I heard that they've seen green light coming from his windows.
Green light?
And that some people go in, they don't come out.
Copper candles, maybe?
Is that what you think it is?
Hypothesis, Amanda.
You know, he's not making pies. You don't have to convince yourself he's nice.
I'm not convincing anything. I'm just trying to... I mean, do we always have to presume everyone's bad?
Asara, I think it would be rude not to let you retcon some snide comments at Krieg and Xenicus for having found out what the pies really were. You can cash that in anytime you like.
Yeah. I'll have to feel some good ones in my heart.
Maybe it's a fae thing. Craig, as he's saying this, he'll like flourish Ooh. The bugs.
Ooh, are they fae?
And like,
we are fae.
Arena, like.
I mean, yeah.
says the Eladra.
Sorry,
yeah, I'm being stupid.
Yeah, that's why he's like excited about it. Yeah. He's like, wait, is this fae?
They're like fae spirits.
Oh, cool.
Irina reaches up and lets one a light on her finger. They're so cute.
Yeah, see, I think so.
Alright, he's now really interested in them. My mom and dad were from there.
Oh!
Irina leads over to you, Xenicus. She's like, watch out. Vanta doesn't like it when you suddenly take interest in things.
Really?
Keep getting in trouble for it.
That's probably just you.
She winks at you, Vanta. And she's still wearing the leather vest with the poofy white sleeves. Just saying.
She's like, I'm not sure if I like you or not.
Yeah, I'm like.
Remember the black leather waistcoat with the white sleeves?
Oh, yeah. That was her fancy outfit.
Yes. She was going to go and see.
I'm still not sure. I still don't
think I like you. Just want to put it out there, everyone. We didn't actually get a meeting for tomorrow. Just saying. People were a little distracted.
I mean, it'll be fine. I can just talk with Isaac and he'll sort it out. But like he said, it's too late today, right?
Yeah, for the Burgomaster, probably, yeah. So that means we could just chill, put our feet up.
Yeah.
Like, he like leans back in his chair more, like, the feet go higher.
Or we could go and interrogate Vasily about what he's keeping in his caravan.
Rictavio?
Rictavio, sorry.
Mm-hmm.
That sounds interesting.
Oh! And we've got that present as well. Oh, I suppose we should probably go hand that present in.
The door opens up as well. The door opens up and, you know, people, a family comes in.
Danica's going back to it and he's going to,
Danica comes out again. She's like, welcome, please. Anywhere you like. And it starts, it's clearly there's a definite, known opening time, and it clearly has got around that neck of the woods because people start to drift in one by one.
Is it a family? Is there kids in the family, or is it just?
There were a couple, yeah, and they actually, it
kind of does the cheers motion towards the kids.
Yeah, Brom, and Bryn, yeah, Bray, sorry. Brom and Bray come scuttling out from behind. They're like, hey! And they know the kids and they're kind of playing together.
Vanta will take one very long look at the alcohol bottle. And she's just going to ask, what is this supposed to do? Why do you drink
You mentioned before your lack of charisma. This is like a charisma potion.
Am I truly lacking in anything? I have all the Raven Queen has given me.
I mean, I'm not.
You give everything to everyone.
Nobody's perfect.
Exactly. That would just be boring.
Can you imagine if you were like everyone else? Scary.
Mm-hmm. So, this helps increase your charisma for a little bit of a constitution hit.
My ultimate goal in life is to resemble the Raven Queen in every single way.
Raven Queen charismatic?
Yes.
And then he puts the bottle in front of you.
And at that point, Soldar and Yevgeny come in. Ah, the brave adventurers.
Drink it quick.
Adventurous.
I pour myself one in my own cup before they can come to the table.
Well.
And
they were complaining about lack of booze last time.
Erwin comes out from the kitchen and he's like, any luck today, fellas? And they're like, yes. We put it around the back. You can clean it up and fillet it as you like. And he's like, ha, splendid, thank you. And he gives them some coin.
Oh, right, they're wolf hunters. Okay.
Yeah, we had a good day. We found nothing yesterday, except you fine folks. But,
Look at that, Zedekus kind of like... kind of sits up and takes a deep drink.
I'm going to give Zenicus a really open look, knowing that no one else knows why I'm giving him a look, but just to bother the shit out of him, just like
he moves a bottle or something, just so it's between your his eye level and your eyes are between the bottles between them.
Rude. Now, is there anyone that you want to talk to, or anything that you would like to talk amongst yourselves? Otherwise, we are going to move on to the end of the evening.
Enough to do.
Vasily comes back and goes and takes a table with Irina, and she's talking with him excitedly. She must be telling him about Isaac, and he looks surprised, and he's like
probably panicking.
That's wonderful.
I'm gonna go outside and get a rock.
That's actually a good point, Zenicus. he doesn't panic at all.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, because Vasily kind of works with thingy, doesn't he? Burgomaster.
He does the taxes and stuff. He's an accountant.
The worst of all criminals.
Full-time job.
As an accountant. Vanta is going to drink. Oh, drink too much. And I think, would Zedekus still be at the table?
Oh yeah, Zedekus is not moving from his chair. Like, he's sunk even deeper into his chair. Like, enjoying chilling out.
Zedekus.
I think...
Yeah.
I can see everything.
That's because your eyes are open.
Give me a constitution saving throw. And by the way, Zedekus, once or twice, Danica stops the boys from pulling your chair out from underneath you.
It's a natural one.
Thunk.
That makes a lot of sense.
The first time I rolled the dice, it landed in the crook of all my other dice, so I was like, oh, I'll quickly roll.
An elven head bounces slightly off the table as it crashes onto the tabletop. And Danica walks by with it and like smiles. She's like, sorry, takes the bottle away. It's done.
Yeah. Zedekus takes what's left of Vanta's cup and pours it into his.
Yeah.
She's fucking dead.
And Soldar and Yevgenia are also celebrating their successful day as well, it seems. They've drunk quite a lot. What else happens during the... Brom will come up to you, Krieg, you know, having made friends with you the night before. And they're like, Mr. Krieg!
What's up, bud?
Did you hear it's my birthday tomorrow? Mother made me a cake.
Oh. I bet it's amazing.
I hope so. I heard Lady Van... Is she okay? Lady Vanta helped, no. helped make... Ooh. Lady Vanta helped make the cake. So it's a special.
That is sure to be good.
Mother says it's a special elven cake.
That does sound very special. I can't wait to try some.
Me too. I'll give you some. Don't worry. I won't let the others eat all of it.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate that.
Then
I
was nodding sagely.
Is there anything that you want?
I bet if you ask really nicely, Craig will give you an egg.
Jesus.
I'm like,
just as I was taking a drink. God. That's close. I'm glad my camera's over here, I'm not looking at my keyboard.
Sara, I don't think it matters how nicely he asks. I can't make that happen.
He said that to everyone, but if he really likes you, he'll give you an A.
Like, no. Big eyes turn to you, Craig.
Damn it.
Then it gets like clinks a glass against.
Yep. I don't do any of that cackling outwardly. That's all internally in Sara's heart.
You see,
like the phrase mischief managed between the two of us is needed.
Danica actually comes out with Bray, and Bray's got like a big like coat on, and he's got like a little backpack. He's like, I think it's got like one of those little knotted handkerchiefs on the stick over his shoulder. And and he's like, now, you make sure, okay, you listen to Mrs. Petrovich, okay? Oh, sorry, no. Petrona it would be, sorry. Petrovna. You do what you're told, okay? Be a good boy. None of your mischief. And he's like, yeah, all right, Mum, no problem. This is the younger brother. And she's like, Are you sure, Drasha? Is it okay? And she's like, yes, of course, they're firm friends. I'll bring him back safe and sound tomorrow. And so, you know, he's leaving for looks like he's going for a sleepover with that family that came in. And he leaves. And Brom turns to you, Krieg, he's like, I'm too old for sleepovers now. I had to stay here and help father look after the inn.
Well, you are the oldest.
And soon I'll be even older. A whole 12. Did you know your name date? Sorry, what was I missed that?
I think he's, is he older than Craig?
He's 15. Yeah. Craig is 15.
He's 16. He's 16.
he's like, yes, very important. Soon I'll be a teenager.
Craig is choking back tears. Yes, you will.
And
oh my god,
the evening carries on. Sorry, I forgot to put this, I meant to put this one on instead. And you have your dinner, and everyone's in there enjoying and having a good old time, and you see people start to drift away. You know, family. You know, the family's gone, and other members of the town go back to their various homes. And you see Yevgeny trying to lift up Soldar, and he's like, he's dead weight. Like Soldar's like as gone as Vanta, and
assume the position.
I think they're like they're kind of like half kind of leaning against each other on the table, just like. And not sure where Vanta's hair ends and Soldar's beard starts. and Danica's just like, Yevgeny, leave him. I'm sure you can cope with a half cold bed for one night.
Hey! Sorry.
You're welcome.
I was very happy.
My heart. Be happy.
Yeah!
Good for
yeah.
Yevgeny looks a bit sulky. He's drunk as well. He's not passed out, but he's drunk. He's like, yeah, he's half cold bit. And she's like, he'll Danica's like, he'll probably wake up in the night, you know. And Yevgeny's like, in the night. And stands up and nods to all of you. He's like, and leaves.
Then it gives him a big smile on his face, gives him a
night.
Oh, he's really adorable.
I'll kill him last.
Wolf hunting.
Hey.
Yeah, kill the children first. Save the gates the lock.
Yeah, they're expecting an egg now. Might as well.
So
that's the easiest way to not give them the egg.
True. So you yes, you're there, and I think you hang out, hoping that Rictavio will return, but he doesn't come back. He doesn't come back into the bar while you're there.
Call it.
And like, kind of ask Irwin, and he's like, no, he hasn't cancelled his room.
Is he alone?
Well, there was that damn monkey.
Just him, the monkey, and the giant animal thing in his.
Yes, Danica told me you said there was something potentially dangerous in his wagon.
Big.
Dangerous.
Okay. We'll have to keep an eye on it. I guess we'll keep the wolf steaks coming, make sure it's not hungry.
Probably wise.
Nah. And he goes off out back. And actually he stops and he comes over and he goes to Irina and he's like, Irina, Your letter was delivered to Barovia. And she's like, she raises an eyebrow. That was fast. He's like, you're welcome. And
that's suspicious.
That
was the post office.
You get to the end of the evening. The fire's dying down. Danica, doesn't want to put more fuel on when it's that time. She's like, do you mind if I close up and get Brom into bed? I don't know if he'll sleep yet, he's so excited.
Vanta's probably resuscitated just enough by this point.
Sarah just like has her under one arm. Come on.
Sleep is...
But it's a real effort because my strength is shit.
Okay.
Vanta's a waif, you're okay.
And Danica's pointedly making exactly zero effort to help. He's watching and giving advice from his like sitting position. Maybe try and heave a bit more.
You're a shit! As I do, advance up the stairs.
Okay.
Asara, you smell nice.
I don't see how that's humanly possible. but thank you.
Yeah, unless you've got one person in the party with prestidigitation, then that's not happening.
You smell like earth, like grave dirt.
There it is. There it is.
Favorite smell.
Grave dirt number 5. anything else before you go off to the land of dreams?
Banta's OG plan was to speak to get some liquid courage to speak to Arena, but that did not work. So I'm just going to go off.
Well, there's always tomorrow.
Yeah.
Got that.
Okay.
That one. Excellent.
So you go off to your separate rooms. Asara, you can dump Banta unceremoniously into the bed. Cover her up with a few wolf furs. Make sure, you know, the windows. Yes. Of course. And Irina goes off to her room. And you all tuck down under the furs and covers and drift off into sleep. No. Senecas.
Oh shit.
Haha, you were so calm as well.
Yeah.
Crick.
Oh.
This is what you both deserve.
It's coming for us.
You didn't.
Oh no, it's pies.
Didn't eat any pie today.
Not for lack of trying.
Senecas. As sleep takes you, and the trance takes you, you smile to yourself in your dream as you see that familiar sight again. The hearth, your siblings under the covers, your mother and father come into the room. They must have another story for you. No, they're arguing about something, shouting at each other in a blind rage. Your siblings all duck under the cover in fear. And you, just before you also go under the covers, see your father lash out. Not towards your mother, but just at the things beside him. He hits what's on the table, overturning it. An oil lamp crashes to the floor. The flames spread across the floor. Onto the covers. All of you are trapped as the room goes up in flames.
Oh shit. That was really fucking cool.
Thank you, Sirenscape.
Yeah, that was appropriate.
I was like, I'll just wait for that moment. Krieg.
Oh, fuck.
Krieg gets no music.
Here we go.
Krieg.
Is it worse?
It's the tree.
Oh, no.
The pie tree again.
Oh, no.
You flap up through the branches once more, spiraling up through and around, the leaves brushing against your feathers. And you see here, there, pies. You reach to pluck one and eat it down like you did before. But you can't. You can't pull it off. It won't come off the branch. You go to peck at it on the branch, but the crust is rock solid. You can't break through to what you know, the deliciousness you know that's inside. Exasperated, you fly up to where you know that giant pie is on top, just waiting for you. You spiral up there, and you see it, and you do one a graceful flip in the air, and starts to dive down, your wings tucked in at your side, towards the giant pie, ready to make another pie angel in the sauce and the gravy. And you know those little holes on the top of pies for the steam to escape? there are those.
Sure.
And it starts to grow. And the hole grows bigger and bigger, almost the size of the pie itself. And as you get closer, you see the filling, and you're like, yes! Yes! And then the teeth spring from the edge of the hole, and just as you go into the pie, into the filling, the teeth slam shut over your disappearing form.
Bird pie.
Fanta.
Oh, fuck! What?
As you can hear, the ravens are very restless. You know, the ravens, you know, roost here all over the rooftops. And you think inside, too. You're sure you saw one inside up in the rafters of the bar as well sometimes, a few times while you've been here.
She doesn't move. Her eyes just pop open.
You kind of blearily come to consciousness briefly out of your trance, and you see Asara trancing over on her bed.
Okay.
And
can I go and look at the window?
You go over to the window, yes. And you see a couple of ravens flying off against the sky. Thank you. There you go. But it seems like they've settled down again. And you're like, oh. Okay. And you go back and slip. Come, please.
Can I actually just make a perception check? I want to see if I can see what was causing them to go a little bit nuts, if anything.
Please do.
16 plus 6, 22.
Well, that's a good roll. So you hear something in the roof space, like the shuffling of clawed feet, like as in raven's feet, sorry, to be careful.
The creatures have a wagon.
No, you do hear ravens up in the roof space, and you think there must be some kind of loft to this structure that you weren't aware of, where they are all nesting, and you hear movement in the inn, but you know it must be Irwin or someone, you know, doing some final rounds or something.
Can I look up at the ceiling and see if there's just anything that looks like a loft entrance?
Not in your room, there isn't, no.
I kind of shuffle on my feet a bit and like instantly like at the door, hand on the handle. And then she stops. Is this 11? Or is this 2? What is this? Where am I? I look at Asara. The Sarah. Sarah.
What?
The ravens.
You can hear what you can hear.
Yes?
There's something in the attic. I need to see it, but I thought it would be a good idea to tell you or get us some help.
She's like in the dark, like trying to focus on like her, and is like, wants to be like, go to sleep, but wants to reward this good behavior. So she's like, okay, let's go look in the attic.
Okay. Oh god, this feels like the kind of choice which is like, and then you died in Barovia, in like Strahd, but still, let's do it.
It was okay. A crow beak. It was, who have we met that's the most sinister? The crow beak in the attic.
Sedated Savage in chat really thinks you shouldn't do that. Thanks for coming by.
A great idea. And it's going to be fine. We're doing it.
Yeah. So, ignore chat. They never scream out good advice. Ever.
I am, don't worry. Don't worry, okay. Yeah.
So we'll be
to Asara and just say,
I'm just happy you ignored them when you know you were buying those pies in Barovia. So you.
No one needs to know.
Slowly unlock the door and go out into the corridor?
Yes. Yes.
Where are you headed?
Asara, did you see anything like I'm going to stage whisper, but Vanta would be whispering because, again, she's also thinking, like, maybe I should be quiet.
I am. Go ahead, sorry.
Did you see anything like a trapdoor or?
Let me look at my passive perception and John can let me know what I would know. So. My passive perception is.
Actually, sorry, your rooms, by the way, I've never actually shown you this, that we do have a map for this, the Blue Water Inn. Your rooms are actually, you have to go up a staircase on the outside.
Cool. Nothing's ever stopped me going.
Let me.
On the roof.
And Irina's is, there's the staircase that's in the tap room, in the bar. That goes up to just, there's a single private room up there that Irina's using. And then you know that around, there's like a dormitory style room on your level as well. And then there's one more room that Rictavio is using, which is on the interior staircase that's same as Irina.
Sure.
Are you showing us this map right now? Because I don't see it,
No, I'm just getting it ready. Sorry, I distracted myself.
No, you're totally fine. I wanted to make sure that I wasn't having technical difficulties. I didn't know that.
No, that's okay.
This is definitely a good idea.
Oh, yeah, completely.
I am following Vanta like a sleeping parent, just like, yeah, where did you see the flying dogs? Like, who just when you're like a child that woke up from a dream.
Here you go.
Xenicus and Krieger with you in spirit.
Yeah.
Okay.
Krieger can't see anything.
Right, so Vanta would say, then let's, is this where the doorway is?
Yes.
Let's go outside.
Can you get through there?
No. Oh, yes, I can. Sorry, I know.
You
I just
jumped off the balcony. Off.
No, I know. I'm trying to go back. Oh, no.
Don't. Go back.
Rush out the door.
It was me. I pushed you. I'm sorry.
Sorry, John. It's being really laggy for me, so I can't control the door.
There you go.
Okay, that's fine.
The door to the north is the one that goes to the staircase, you know. I might as well just get rid of these doors. They're closed when you're not using them, but yeah. I don't want to faff with them all the time. There you go. So yeah, you come out onto the balcony and you can see Soldar is still down there. Passed out. Maybe it was him you heard like shifting in his sleep. In one of the chairs. Go back onto the balcony for a sec.
Yeah.
I should let chat see what's going on here as well. Just a moment.
This feels questionable, but I'm going along with it.
So yeah, that to your left there, so to the west there, is open down to the bar area. And you can see the stairs that outside, the ones that lead to the north there are outside, going down to the bottom. And you can see Soldar sleepily lolling in his chair down there. And do you open the door to go down the stairs?
Yes.
Okay. Please. I shall try and keep up with you.
Off we go. Do-do-do-do-do.
So you are outside.
No,
actually, I'll have to zoom out and put you. Actually, no, I don't
John,
have to zoom
can
out.
John, ask a question, which might be a bit cheeky. you know, the hour or so where we were drinking downstairs and not really doing that much, and Banter was passed out on the table.
Mm-hmm.
Would you consider that a short rest?
I think, no, from being passed out and drunk, no, sorry.
I'm so gonna die. This is fine. Back to my queen. Right, round the corner.
Okay, 2 seconds. Let me put you on the ground floor. So you get to here. So go down the page from where you were.
Yeah.
Hello, boys. It just came past you briefly.
Sedated savage. I'm so sorry that we're... don't get fired because of us.
Yes. Priorities. But thank you for coming by.
Hey.
You're very welcome.
So,
I'm just like, and now we're outside. And
you are. So you know, that's, you know, the main doors are there, Vanta. That's the steps there to the main doors. I think. I don't. Have we even used this map before? Hang on. Yes, that is the main. That's the main room.
Isara.
Yeah. Huh.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you for thinking of me. Thank you for not going off by yourself. Thank you for not...
Thank you so much, yes.
Getting eaten by a wolf, or... Let's not count our chickens before our hatch. Let's go. Let's go.
Okay, I'm going to go inside. Okay. Quietly.
I'm just going to boop you in.
Uh-huh, I see Solda.
Hello. Oh, he doesn't say that.
Would it be incredibly stupid of me to make a call at that? No. Okay, can I make a perception check? See if I can hear or see, hear any noises, see if I can see an attic room or an entrance.
Just a moment, please. Sorry, I wasn't expecting this to happen, so shifting things out of the way that I just left lying around. Okay, so
expecting us to be the players to be smarter than what they actually are. Terrible.
Foolish.
I'm
foolish.
Rewarding good behavior.
Yeah.
True. Oh, that's brave. Sorry, 2 seconds. Okay. So yes, sorry, you want to look for a way up north? Up top? Sorry.
Yeah. The north, yeah.
To Santa.
Who is Santa? My name is Vanta. They're very different.
So yeah, you're going up to the where Irina and Rictavio's rooms are?
Yeah. I think that seems to be the only way that we're going to get close to the ceiling.
So mm-hmm.
Sure. And there's the kitchen door there as well, you can see.
I feel like because we heard things were coming from the roof.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Let me go back to the second floor. Hang on. So you hold still for a sec. I'll move you up.
Yep.
This is like betrayal.
Craig and Zenica are having a wonderful time chilling in the...
chilling and watching everything burn or being cooked into pies.
At least you're on the same screen, so I can put you in there. Hello. Okay. So yeah, you come around and that balcony is entirely interior. That just runs around the side of the bar there, and it, you know, above the bar and looking down on the main room towards the front doors.
Gotcha.
Mm-hmm. And across, you can see the door to your room and the boys' room across the way there.
Should we have brought the boys?
The boys are useless. Just please be quiet. I don't want to.
Very fair comment.
Would you help me have a look for this entrance?
Yeah. And were the entrance like just down the balcony, or we're looking into the door?
Looking up to see if there's an attic entrance anywhere we can see.
Mm-hmm. So give me a perception check.
Can we help each other, or is this both of us rolling?
You can either roll separately, or one can aid the other.
2.
Yeah. 13 plus 6, 19.
Nice. From the balcony here, no. There's no way up. Are you like searching down the length of the balcony then?
Yes. Well, I was thinking that I would be able to see the whole ceiling from here, but if that's not the case, then I'll keep going until I've seen everything I can.
Okay, so you go make your way down.
Yeah, I'm just looking.
Yep. You do that. And as you're making your way down the balcony there, looking up at the ceiling, looking around, trying to find some way up to above, the door down the end of the balcony at the top of the steps bangs open, and Brom, the 12-year-old boy, comes barreling out of the door. He's like, and he goes down the stairs into the tap room, and you see on the wall of the tap room, like built into the wall, there's like little like decorations, and like there's wolf heads, taxidermied wolf heads, and like, and there's like, you know, like a lantern fixture and stuff. And he goes up this, like, you know, very practiced maneuver clearly, and he vaults over onto the balcony of the other side, back to where your room is. But he runs past your door and runs to the boy's door, to Krieg's door, and just starts hammering on the thing. Mr. Krieg, please, Mr. Krieg, she's coming. And you see, oh no, it's too late. Please, Mr. Krieg.
Let's check out that room.
Let me finish. Vanta, you and Asara see coming down through the ceiling and drifting across the empty bar space a spectral greenish glow in a faintly female form, tapering out into nothingness at the bottom, drifting after, chasing after Brom. And as he's hammering that last desperate hammer on the door, and it just goes quiet, because you just see the ghost just go inside Brom and disappears into him, and his arms just drop at his side, and he turns and starts walking towards the stairs to the outside, opens the door, and disappears from view, clearly onto the exterior steps.
Well, I'm going. I'm out. I'm intrigued.
Are you running?
I kind of want to go in the room. Running out, yeah.
Okay, so you run down to the tap room?
Yeah. We have to see if we can catch him.
Yeah.
Mm. Zinicus. Yeah, you and Zinicus, what do you do? Hold still. That's all right.
We heard just loud banging.
That definitely would have woken me up.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Like, Zedekus is like, oh, what the hell? Like, putting on his, like, armor. Like, oh, dang.
There we go.
What has Vanta done now?
So,
because he heard she's coming to get me, and he's like, oh, what's she done?
And you are going to do what, please? The door's open. Creak. I think you react faster with your name being called, and you run over to the door and throw it open, but you just see the top of Rom's head disappearing down the stairs, like slowly walking towards the outside, down the outside. You're gonna run after?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay.
I might try to fly after him.
You run to the top of that doorway, that northern doorway that leads out to the exterior stairs, and you're kind of taken aback, because like you saw his head disappearing just down below the top of the stairs, and you rushed directly after him. And as you get to the top, he's already down the bottom, and like walking back behind you towards the front door. So you just vault over the thing and glide down to the bottom. And Xenicus, you're behind him, right?
Yeah, slowly walking out, not knowing that there's actually a danger yet. Loud noises.
Okay, so I'm just gonna put you back there. As you and Vanta get to the bottom of the stairs, this is all happening at the same time. As you get to the bottom of the stairs, the front doors open. And you see Brom, just slack-jawed, arms at his side, walk in through the front door. And coming after him really very quickly, you see Krieg running after him. And he comes to here. Xenicus, where are you?
Where he is, he's just kind of getting to the top of the staircase.
Right, I think you get out onto the balcony, you see this, you see Brom appear below you. In the thing here, I'm gonna put you here, which is you're okay. Above that.
Above,
yeah. Okay. The balcony is directly above section of the tap room there, the front door. You see Brom just like steps into the middle, and like looks around just without any recognition on his face, at you. Sees Soldor slumbering there. He's like, his head goes up and his mouth just opens, and this ectoplasmic kind of green mist just kind of erupts up out of his mouth into the air above, and immediately that's coming up towards you, Xenicus, as you looked over the balcony, you pull back instinctively, and then, but it doesn't come for you, it immediately just swoops down and goes whoosh, into Soldar's body.
If you kill the gaze,
no,
I will kill you.
And Brom, his head slaps back down. And he's like, and he runs to you, Krieg, and like grabs onto you, like, Mr. Krieg, she was after me.
What happened? What happened?
Krieg, can you get the boy out of here?
Yeah, of course.
Everyone.
There's a smash and a clash of glasses as Soldar lurches to his feet, upsetting the table and the glasses that were left on there.
Vanta, can you stop hearing noises in the middle of the night? And I'm going to start walking.
And he looks, hey Scrappy, and he looks at you and he's like, get out. Get out of the inn.
Xenicus is going to jump off the balcony and try and slam into him with his shield, putting his weight on his shield and landing to try and knock him out.
If any of you kill the gaze, I will destroy you. But yes,
trying to knock him out. Specifically use that phrase.
Give me an attack roll with disadvantage. It's improvised weapon.
Improvised? He's proficient in shields.
For defense, yes.
attack. So it's just improvised weapon. So not without my proficiency bonus then, yeah.
Yes. Okay. Just your strength.
Just my strength?
Yeah, it's a bludgeoning attack, right?
Right, but it's my weight on it.
That's not much better.
That's kind of fun.
Then this was the worst idea. Oh, well. Yeah. I roll the same thing twice, so that is an 8 minus 1.
Okay. He, he's quite far away from you, so it's quite an awkward jump. And you take 6 damage from the fall as you crash into the table down here. And Soldar just turns to you, and you just see his eyes just roll up in his head, and his mouth droops open much broader than than would be normal. And he just... screams in a strangely female voice and just pulls out a huge hunting knife and goes to attack you. Mm-hmm. We need some initiative, please.
Okay, I want to get some jabs in. When Asara sees Xenicus just fall from the balcony, she's going to be like, who was that for?
That's funny.
Okay, I'll stop trying to be creative.
That's good.
Initiative. Oh, wow, that's terrible.
Oh, so is mine. But I'm a healer, so it makes sense. Guys, I have one spell slot.
Yep.
And 13 HP, just so you know. Yes. 4, 5. I'll go for that in there. What is Wendy?
I rolled mine, so can I get my token up still?
Yeah.
Okay. Usually I use the thing that does automatically, but I rolled it by mistake.
Okay.
Craig, so, get it.
Let's get into this. Yes, Krieg, you are quickest to react. You kind of like pushed Bron behind you.
Okay. So I think what I'm going to do here is, like you said, I'm going to push Bron behind me to kind of get him out of out of immediate harm. And I am going to try to can I make a called shot?
Yes, it'd be a disadvantage.
Right.
You do know, I mean, if you're wanting to knock him out, arrows are not the way to go.
Right, yeah. Okay. I guess we're gonna go, probably unarmed then. We're gonna go with a talon attack.
Okay.
And I'm trying to just kind of get, I'm trying to be non-lethal.
Mm-hmm. That's fine. So you kind of flap over to the table.
Yeah. I will move over towards the table and it's a dirty 20 to hit.
Nice, that hits.
All right. It is not much damage though.
What is it?
2 damage.
Okay. It's a start.
Yeah.
Anything else?
I'll try to say something to him, like, Soldar, what's going on?
He just does that unearthly scream at you. He's just, his eyes just white in his back in his head, and his mouth just gaping open. So you spread your wings and you whoosh and, you know, just do a quick, like, power jump almost, like, over to the table there, like, landing on top of the table next to him?
Yeah.
Right? And then just kick him with your talon, okay, across the cheek. And he's, like, gets knocked by that. And Xenicus, you pull yourself up off the floor.
Yep. Pulls out his weapon.
Yes.
So that he's ready for parrying. Well, I'm getting weird feedback. So he's ready to parry whatever comes in. But he's going to try and just, like, you said he's got, like, he's holding, like, a knife or something?
He's got a hunting knife, yeah.
He is... Actually, no, sorry, he's not going to pull out his weapon. He's going to, like, he's got his shield still attached to one arm, and he's going to try and grab onto his arm, just, like, hug into that arm that's got the knife to just kind of like grapple that arm, just like put his whole weight on it so that he can't do this to slash Craig or anyone else.
Okay, try and grapple so give me the strength check.
It's not going to go well. Oh, not too bad. 15, so the 16 minus 1.
15, okay. He gets 17, I'm afraid. With his deck, so he kind of slips out of it. Just like, his body's moving strangely as well. It's like clearly not under his own control. He just like goes limp and just like drops down, but then comes back up on his knees, like springs back up in your face. Anything else? So
with that, like as he kind of springs around, he's gonna like roll past him, kind of get behind him, just kind of keep him distracted from the rest of the part.
Okay.
And draw.
Right, so, Krieg, you're here, aren't you? So,
yes.
He...
can't see anything on my roll 20, so I...
Oh, okay, sorry. I'll keep track of that for you. Soldar's body, tracks your movements, Xenicus, and swings after you and lunges for you with the knife. Getting... only a 10. That misses, I assume.
Yes, miss.
Yeah, so he just only gets a 10, so he misses with that. And then the body just immediately just pivots round, and the attack comes before his head comes round and meets you, Krieg. The arm just comes slashing around at you. And for only an 8.
Yeah, no good.
And he brings the knife up again, like to try and stab up at you on the table there, for 24, there we go.
Yeah, that's gonna hit.
So that is 6, is that right? Yeah, 6 piercing.
Okay.
You feel the hunting knife slice your side as he lunges up at you, just like... Okay, and Asara Bell.
Yes, I'm gonna use my bonus action to do insightful fighting.
Yes.
So it's my insight check against your deception check.
Okay, thank you very much. Boom, I get a 15.
I got a 12.
Oh, bad luck.
It's so bad luck because I have a +6 on that.
Ooh.
I am going to run up here behind the table.
Okay, Vantir, next.
Yeah.
I'm tucked behind here.
Yep. They will give half cover.
So I'm gonna go ahead and do my short bow first, which is 22 to hit.
It's...
and that will be 7 piercing.
Okay. That's a very nasty cut across Soldar's neck. The arrow just goes, cuts across. And Krieg, you see blood start to pump into his furs, into the wolf furs.
And I'm like disappointed, but like this has to. And I... not knowing his wherewithal, I'm going to stop but keep the half cover and
okay.
Stay there.
I see. Phantom.
Yeah. Here's what I want to try. I'm going to... okay. I don't know if this is going to do anything. I'm going to pull my... have this today as my trinkets bag. I'm gonna pull my jewelry box with my items in it,
mm-hmm.
and hold it in my hand. And Vanta looks like she's kind of like reluctant to do it, but she opens it up and she sort of goes and starts whispering. But she sounds like it's like multiple voices at once, all whispering together as she channels divinity.
Okay.
And I'm going to do... I'm not going to do Turn Undead, because I don't want him to run away, because he's in Soldar's body. I'm going to try to Twilight Sanctuary. As an action, you present your holy symbol and a sphere of twilight emanates from you. The sphere is centered on you, has a 30-foot radius, and is filled with dim light. The sphere moves with you, lasts for a minute. Whenever a creature, including myself, ends its turn in the sphere, I can grant it one of these benefits. Either I can give them 1d8 temporary HP, mm-hmm. or I can end one effect, causing it to be charmed or frightened.
Okay.
So what I want to do
is that?
I'm reading them on a sheet. Right.
I put the zone on for you, so it's, they're just outside it at the moment.
Yeah. Cool. So first, I'm going to just move so that everybody can be caught in it. That's probably about right.
Okay.
Now, I want... I want to move a bit more, actually, just so that I know that they're going to stay in it.
Okay.
Sure. Cool. And I'm... Can I make like some kind of insight check whether I could ascertain if Soldar looks like he's being charmed or frightened? Or being affected by any sort of external force?
I mean, we saw the green lady flying.
We saw what happened. I'm trying to learn whether in terms of mechanics, whether or not
in your profession and being, you know, of the Raven Queen, you know that he is being possessed by a ghost. And he's not charmed or frightened. But the ghost is controlling his body and is inside the body.
So that wouldn't be like an effect, that's like a condition. I don't know if there's a different action. I think there's something.
Yeah, it's just a special thing for being possessed.
Okay, so but I can't. It says I can end an effect causing it to be charmed or frightened.
But it's not charmed or frightened.
Cool. Then I'm going to give everybody 1d8 temporary HP.
Okay.
When do we get that? Is it on your turn or on our turn?
When you end your turn in the sphere.
Okay, on our turn.
If that's the case, actually, I'm going to move away so that Soldar doesn't get that.
Well, I mean, I guess, like, he's not an ally.
Yeah, he's not an ally. Yeah, that's fine. Yep, sweet, that's it. And I need those HPs, so I'm just going to give them to myself right now. Yay. Because I'm ending my turn.
Yep.
That's
pretty strong, eh?
That aura? Yeah, because I can't see that aura, so am I inside it?
Yes.
Okay,
cool. It's covering the entire room.
Okay, yeah. Not sure. I'm going to try.
Okay, thank you very much. Krieg.
I can only do this once.
I think Krieg, Brom kind of shouts out to you, like screams out. He's like, Mr. Krieg, don't kill Uncle Soldar.
Oh, yes. I have another one.
That's the last thing I want, buddy. He's dealing with something real bad right now. We have to try to kick it out of him. And at that, I will...
Kick him.
I'll kick him.
Kick him. Seem like this.
Double power. I get this.
Actually, would it be possible to, like, I don't know, put something over his head?
Do you have anything? I mean, I think you rushed out of the room. You didn't really have anything to hand.
Okay.
Yeah, there's nothing in the bar itself.
Okay.
Take off your shirt.
Greg doesn't wear a shirt.
Okay.
Already done. Way ahead of you.
Shit. Oh, okay. I am wearing my hat, though.
Ah, with your hat!
Can I, like, put the hat on his head backwards?
Sure.
Okay.
Give me a sleight of hand check.
Sure.
Now I will give him a dex save.
Okay, I got a 21.
Ooh. And I got a 10.
Cool.
So yeah, you see.
It's an aviator hat, but it's like a leather thing, like.
Yep, the aviator helmet. Yep.
Yeah.
So yeah, you just like slam it over him.
Yep. Okay. And then, Is that my action, or can I?
Yeah, that would be an action.
Okay, all right. Well, worth it.
Nice. Chat says you are Donald Ducking it. But without the top half as well. As Donald Duck as you can be. Okay, so you just slam that over his head, and then you're just gonna, you're holding it on, like holding the straps around him.
Yes.
Okay.
I see. Then he gets that D8 from Banta if his turn's over.
Yep.
Eight.
Roll yourself a D8.
Temporary hit point.
And Xenicus. He is blinded.
So, yeah. Two quick questions. First quick question is, to recall information, like, about what I would know about this from my studies, would that be an action?
I think we've talked a lot about you being a monster hunter, not really dealing with ghosts so much, right?
Oh, okay. I just wondered, because, like, that is one of the main, like, schools. Not the one that I specifically in, but it is one of them. I just wanted to know if I know about possession, just in general.
I don't think so. Sorry.
Okay.
This Tycho is brought to you by Sirenscape. Not, this is one I added. I have other ones where I added Tycho drums, but this one.
It says, like, fiend, it says, fey, fiend, and undead.
Okay.
For the ability. That's
well,
why I was just wondering.
I shall shut myself up.
No, I was just wondering about it. It was just because. Yeah.
No, that's good.
Is that an action, though, to recall information? That's because if it's an action, I'm not.
No, because this is just stuff you know.
Yeah, cool.
So this is your.
Well, I mean, the first one was a nat 20, but I'll roll again. That was a. So it was a 20, and that would be intel, and that would be. Wait a minute. Oh wait, 2 seconds.
Which ability is this?
I may have misread it, so give me a quick second.
Which one is it?
It was the...
Hunter's Bane?
Yeah, but I think that's for tracking. So
yeah,
I
it's just for tracking them,
it. Yeah. Because I saw the little advancement symbol next to my thing, I got was like, ooh, can do that, but no,
gotcha,
that's only while tracking.
Yeah, just to
survive. Oh wait, no, it says, to recall information about Fey, Fiends, or Dead.
Okay.
Hunter's Bane.
So yeah, give me an intelligence check. With
so that, it was a nat 20.
Okay, so yeah, you remember everything that Banta heard about before as well. I know, Scrappy, it's like full on what I call here. And for people watching, all of us are in Japan, so we're enjoying this Taiko.
Like,
we've got no festivals this year.
Yeah, but it's like the possession, like, I don't know any way of like how you generally get rid of these possessions.
You think that, I mean, if the vessel became useless to the spirits, then it would probably leave it.
Okay.
Or a certain clerical abilities can drive out undead.
Okay. Then there's nothing else in the room that I see that I could quickly use to like tie him down while he's blinded.
Not immediately at hand, no. No, it's just the chairs. Like everything's been cleared away for the night.
No, like curtains or anything?
No, it's the board there shuttered on the outside. I know, on the inside, but shuttered.
I don't want to just hit this guy like a normal hit, so I feel like I need to do a bit.
I mean, you can do non-lethal, right? You can just knock him out.
Yeah, but it's the thing, like, because, like, I'm useless unless I'm using a weapon, and weapons going to be, like, cutting him and stuff, so.
No, you can use a weapon for non-lethal. You can state it's non-lethal, just like the flash of the blade or whatever.
Yeah.
But that's still be like using Dex? That feels like it's then strength then.
I mean, it doesn't say anything. It doesn't say anything like that. You know, it says if you just, you know, when you're attacking, you just state that it's non-lethal and you're aiming to knock them out. It doesn't state that you can only use these attacks.
Yeah. Then if that's possible, then I'll do it. And I presume that was like you're having to like put your weight behind it kind of thing, like what I was doing with, like with the shield thing and stuff. But if I can use my weapon, then he will. So he'll take out his weapon, and he's gonna like just kind of like try and whack him in the back of the like just behind the knees, trying to knock him down.
Okay.
Well, he's blinded.
Give me the advantage.
Cool. Ooh, 12. Or that is 19 plus 7. I think that's 4 and a half.
That'll hit, yep.
That is 6 plus 7. 13.
13 damage?
Yeah.
Okay. So yeah, you with the flat of your sword, yes?
Yeah.
Yeah, you just like smack him across the back of the knees. And they buckle underneath him. And Krieg instinctively lets him fall. He takes the hat with him, but he just cracks off the table. His chin just cracks off the table. Ooh. And he just falls to the ground, unconscious. And there is a scream of frustration and anger as the from his jaws, it's lolling open, unconscious on the floor. The green specter of this woman again rises up out of the body and flees. I say flees. It like comes rising up between you and Zenica's Krieg, and you're looking at it, and you're like ready to act, and it just goes.
Ah, shit.
And dissipates.
Bam.
As they disappear into the ethereal plane.
I was like, but it actually fled, I could have tracked it.
And damn. Yes, they go off into the ethereal. We are out of initiative.
That's the Baron.
Shit.
The Baron?
The Baron?
The Burgomaster?
Yes.
What if it was haunting him too? Maybe he's also infected.
Krieg, there's a thump as Brom like barrels into the back of you. Hugs onto you, he's like, thank you. Thank all of you.
Yeah, no problem, buddy. I'm glad that we were able to get you safe. Hey, can you run into the kitchen and get like a towel or something?
Yeah, like Zedek is trying like with his minus one strength to put him in a chair.
Can someone come with me?
It's probably a good idea.
Yeah, and I go with him begrudgingly because I don't want to. I'm like, I don't want to. All right, yeah, but you're a kid. I have to go with you.
John, I want to make a medicine check.
Please do.
22.
Okay. Yeah, he's fine. Do you have a health kit? The equipment. Okay.
There's like a medicine kit. I've got a herbalism kit.
Fanta, you've got one. Yep.
I do, but funnily enough, Fanta is going upstairs. Ha ha ha. So if you want it from her, you'll have to get it from her.
Okay.
Oh shit, no. I have my herbalism kit, not my medicine kit.
Okay. So you and Brom go into the kitchen and he grabs what you're looking for and comes back out with it. And he's like, here you are, Mr. Krieg.
Thanks, buddy. And I'll like press it into Oldard's neck.
Okay.
Trying
to
stabilize everything.
Yeah, he's fine. He's not bleeding out. It does seem to staunch it that nicely, and it does slowly stop. And he looks like he's going to be okay. But he's unconscious.
Doubly so.
It doesn't come for us.
Yes, but yeah, it seems that this is related to the Burgomaster, but I'm not going to jump to conclusions yet.
Would you like to come investigate with me? Vanta calls from the top of the balcony.
Yes.
Brom.
Okay. Zenica's not wanting to leave another person alone.
Brom calls to you. He's like, but my parents.
Yeah, we're gonna go check on them. Aren't they up here?
No, they came down here.
Oh.
Where?
They said it was like about 2 hours ago. They said they had to check downstairs and they didn't come back. Please find them and make sure that thing doesn't come back.
I'm gonna stay here with Brom. You guys, please go check that out.
It's on this floor. I'm gonna immediately start yelling for Danica.
Mm-hmm. calling out for them.
Yes.
Yeah.
We should wake Arena as well. Is Vanta still going upstairs no matter what?
She's looking at the door like, the ravens were upstairs. The ravens were upstairs.
And the ravens brought us to the pies.
The ravens brought us to this glowing witch. Can we please take care of the people who are alive? Hopefully. Who are alive? And I look at Bronn. No, they're alive.
Yes.
Bronn,
thank you.
Is there an attic, an entrance, something like that you know of?
No.
No. You are useless to me. Right?
Vanta.
You are a child.
Do yes. you guys have like a secret playroom that you guys go to sometimes?
No.
Do your parents?
As a father of four, I'm ignoring that. So, Sarah, you look around, and there's only the kitchen. That's the only other door out that you've already been to.
Can I make looking for footprints or signs of people leaving be? Would that be like
the investigation or survival if you're looking for footprints?
I'm looking
That's tracking in the wild though, but
signs. Just
give me perception or perception it would be. To actually find something. Investigation to figure out what it actually means.
Did Vanta go upstairs or did she come back down?
She's coming back down.
Cool. Then.
Sorry, Asara, once more.
19.
Thank you. You see marks, recent marks, and kind of like scuff marks and around a trap door in the kitchen as you're looking around.
So they do have a secret playroom, is what you're saying.
You open that?
Yeah.
Okay. You see, let me just get this right here. Yeah, there's a heavy trapdoor there behind the bar. Sorry, excuse me, not to the not in the kitchen. And you open it up, and there's a fixed ladder inside, and it leads down, and you can see a small unlit cellar kind of room below that. And this is the direction that the ghost was kind of heading before it whooshed into the ethereal.
Can I see? Can I do another perception check?
Zeneca so with her at this. He does not want anyone going anywhere by themselves.
As you hoist up the trapdoor and look at peering down into the gloom, you actually hear a sound. You hear a
Oh, it's awful.
Which one of you punched me? Kicked me?
Yeah.
Hit me with a table.
God. I point at the kid.
Brom, are you okay? Where are your parents? They've disappeared, Mr. Uncle Solda.
He looks at you. Krieg, you're still next to him, right? In that,
yeah.
that area. He looks, he's like...
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I'll say for one thing. That is a sobering experience.
Vanta, you should try it.
I'm gonna look up from behind the bar and be like, I'm sure you're in no position to help, but could you go get your man? And
maybe get Arena. Just upstairs.
I'm... maybe... in somewhat of a position to help.
He's like still clutching at his neck, holding the towel in place.
Perfect.
I bet I know who that was.
You do?
I know, I missed it.
I bet I know who that was.
Oh.
It was Eliza.
Eliza.
There is a legend. And you will remember Vasily mentioning something similar. There is a legend of a ghost that has haunted this inn for decades, even before the Martikovs came here. Her name is Eliza. He looks slightly concerned to Brom, and he's like, "No, you're a big 12-year-old boy now, huh? It's your name day. Happy name day." And Brom's like puffs up, like proud. He's like, "Yeah, I can hear the story." And he's like, "It's not a nice one. The legend says that Eliza was abducted and murdered here in the inn, but nobody knows by whom. She drifts around the halls, searching for her son so that she can say goodbye, and also looking for her killer so she can take vengeance." "I heard Arwen talking about a locked door down in that cellar."
He points to where you are, Asara.
"They've never been able to get it open. They don't have a key for it. Apparently, it leads to some empty cistern? A well, water in a cavern?" Erwin always wondered what was behind that door, and if it was connected to that legend. "Maybe you should go knocking, huh?"
Can't hear you. Muted.
"Oh no, I said I'm already going. I'm down here. I'm in it."
you drop
it's
down.
Happening.
Like, then it was listening to the story, turned, like, here's the stump of you landing. Goes to fall.
And he looks, Krieg, Solda looks at you, he's like,
"Don't worry. You flushed that bleach right out. I'll stay here with Brom."
Very go good. On. Thank you.
Find Erwin and Danica. Bring them back.
Go with meet Arena. The more people together, the safer you'll be.
Like, as soon as Soldar is finished talking, Krieg is going to, like, take off up towards Irina's room to, like, alert her.
And she actually, as you, like, fly up, she actually comes, like, blearily eyed out onto the balcony. She's like, "What's going on? I heard a commotion."
Craig was definitely going so fast that, like, as he hits the, like, the crest of the balcony, mm-hmm. he, like, whoa, like...
And her, so she's like,
"Arakokra."
"So, sorry, Arena.
No, please. Do a couple of laps." What's happened?
"We've got a ghost situation."
"Oh, a ghost."
And she runs around and down the stairs, and then she sees Soldar, and she's like,
"Oh, Soldar, what's happened to you? Yevgeny's going to be cross."
And Soldar's like, "Oh gods, I drank too much. He's going to be cross enough already." And she's like, "Let me look at that.
I had to stitch up Ismark once or twice when he was practicing his swordplay, trying to be as good as me."
And she's like,
Brom, come here. Let me show you what to do."
And he's like, "Oh yeah." And he comes over, and they kind of like closet themselves at a table, and they're all busying amongst themselves. And yes, are you going to join Asara?
I'm in there.
Yeah.
I already have.
So, yeah. You have Anta, you too? Okay.
Yeah.
I am picking back up my hat and putting it on, though.
Okay. And let me just copy... Oh, no, not you, Solda. QRP.
And coming over to this new map that is not in the module. Hey everyone, for those watching that are interested, this is a fantastic Halloween release from Arcane Library, if you want to check it out. It's spooky and cool. Okay, so let me bring you across. I have, never mind.
I was going to say, over there.
Yeah, you already there. Oh, get in the boat. Don't go through the wall. Cheeky. Let me get the thing. Oh, that's also pretty useful. Nice and close. Oh, hello.
Somehow.
Stop clipping through the wall.
I have no idea how that happened. I pressed up and then it wouldn't move up, so I pressed down and it moved through the wall.
Stop it. Stay there.
There we go.
Okay, so let me describe this room and we shall leave the rest until Halloween week next week.
Oh no.
Didn't I time it well? You pressed. Okay, so there's a bundle of four adventures. This one is called Beneath the Black Rose, renamed for our purposes to Beneath the Blue Water Inn. Mm-hmm. You find yourself in a basement full of boxes and barrels that fill up this damp, lightless space. Over in the corner, you see a wooden door lurking, covered in dust and cobwebs. That's all right. Care to do the honors?
Covered in dust and cobwebs, I'm gonna...
Yep, brush it free.
Yes.
And... Are you gonna... You try it, it's locked. You going to try and open that up?
Yes, I will.
Okie doke.
Let's see.
By the way, like as you were like just like pottering around in the tap room there and stuff and helping Soldo, I checked and he was unconscious for an hour, so you can take a short rest.
Yes, please.
If you like.
Yes, please.
So please, yes, all that. You did not get a long rest. You were woken
short.
How'd you go, Sarah?
I'm so sorry. I clicked on Thieves Cant. It doesn't tell me what
thieves
to roll.
Thieves Cant.
Thieves
no,
tools.
No, it's a sleight of hand dexterity check. I think it's actually a straight dexterity check, but with your proficiency bonus. So you have a...
16 total. I got... 10 plus 4 for my dex and plus 2 for my proficiency, so 16.
Okay. So yeah, you sit down and you work, and it takes a little while. This is very old, hasn't been worked for a long time, and there's a bit of resistance, but after working at it for a while, you hear a click, satisfyingly so. You like turn around with a smile to the others.
We're in. Like, I make a kind of like, yay, sarcastic face, like for better or worse.
Yes. Who is going to open the door?
Me! I worked on it.
I earned this. Okay. So, yes.
The man with the shield looks at you and is like, all right then.
And you turn the handle and you have to give it quite a serious tug because it's like kind of sealed shut. And kind of the timbers have warped a little with age. And you pull it open.
Creak sound effect. Creak sound effect.
There we go.
And you open the door. And behind it, you just see darkness. By the way, Creak, you cannot see very much. There is some light spilling up from above, but you'll need something going forward.
Great fire.
And you see darkness beyond, but with your night vision, you see stairs leading down, and the smell of stagnant water rises from the darkness. And we shall stop there. To be continued in Halloween week. Thank you all so much. Good job, well done. And thanks everyone for popping by. It's great to have everyone in chat. Thanks.
Thank you everyone.
Thank you.
And do join us next week and see what lies beneath the Blue Water Inn.
What death awaits us.